Okay, guys, are you all ready?
Yes.
All right. I'm sure today you all will be ready and you go back. Okay, something else happening. Now, the topics are there, okay? And every time you talk, we will ask questions. I will go back to this chart where I will ask questions. Okay, this is a chart I'll be using. Okay? And we will match when we build the comedy material, we ask whether it has a target, hostility. Is it real? Is it is there exaggeration, emotion, surprise, you know, and whether it matches any part of the things that we're talking about here. Now, of course, I switch off this one, just the two TV screen will do, okay? So this one, I have to write, and then you will see for yourself. Okay, we ask for volunteers. Who wants to go first? Who? Just come out here, okay? If you have a material, you can tell. If not, we will start building your material. Okay? Yep. Come.
Yes.
Speak
whatever. So what am I supposed to say?
Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Wikid from Puchun English Toastmasters Club. Okay.
How do you take it up? Eh? Oh.
Okay. And yeah.
How many children do you have? Tell me something about yourself.
Okay, experience. Okay, I've joined Toastmasters for 2 years. And I've taken some of the contests as well. And for humorous contests, I've been facing the difficulty to actually crack jokes. People just don't laugh at my jokes. Oh, when it's one-to-one, it's funny, but when you bring it up to the stage, it's not that funny. Perhaps the way I deliver, the way I pause and stuff might not be right.
So which topic would you like to look at? Arts, business, or anything?
Arts, business. What about...
What do you want to talk about?
What about family?
Okay.
Right.
Okay, family. What do you want to talk about your family? Your mother, your father, your auntie, your birthday...
Auntie? Yeah.
Do you have auntie or not?
Yeah, I have.
Okay. So you want to talk about your auntie, yeah?
Yep, yep.
Okay. Your name again is?
Wikid.
Wikid, okay.
Yep.
So you know you are Wikid, your age?
25.
You're from Puchong.
I'm from Sabah, but now from Puchong English Toastmasters Club.
Puchong, Sabah, same thing.
Yeah, almost the same.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
You just mentioned a good opening line.
Okay.
Okay, this is called happy accident. Now, so you are from Puchong. As we go along, you just hold on. Now what we do now is we start building for you. Yeah, but see first. Okay. Would you like to spell your name?
D-U-I-K-I-D.
Okay.
B-U-I-K-I-D.
A-I-T. Okay, so you are from Sabah.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, now you live in Puchong. Okay. Okay. This time you mentioned earlier. Hola, my name is Ricky. I'm actually from Sabah, but I live in Puchong. But Puchong, Sabah, what's the difference? Same lah, you know? So that is the delivery part of it. Okay, now this is one line for you. Okay, what else you want to talk about? Your family. Okay, you talk about family, your auntie. Okay, guys. Help him to build a story about his auntie. Timba, when you talk about aunties, what are some of the things related to aunties?
Nagging.
Huh?
Nagging.
Okay, nagging. Good. Come on. What else?
Gossiping.
Gossiping. Nagging. Gossiping. Very good. Okay.
Boasting.
Boasting. Yeah. Okay. Now, in comedy, we have one subject, three topics, let's build another three more topics, okay? Okay, so nagging, what do they nag?
Marriage.
Huh? Marriage. What? Okay. Marriage, what else do they nag?
Children.
Get a good job.
Get a job, okay? And they nag you, okay. They don't nag other beer, okay? Huh?
You
cannot go home, okay, what else? Anybody there? Anything? Marriage. They think about children, they think about jobs. Okay. Why do you think they what do they say when they nag about marriage? What do they say?
When are you getting married? Okay. Now, you see the building of the materials will be 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1. I will show you where it goes. So basically here is about 1 minute, 30 seconds, but then you should have your thing already. Okay. When are you getting married? When? Okay, that's when are you getting married? Okay, what else? Right now, it's yours. Okay, now this is what I'm gonna do now. What our job is today, together we build the materials for each other. Okay? You see, on our own, you sit down there, I bet you now it's less than 1.5 minutes we got this, right? On your own, it tell you, you sit in a toilet bowl for 1 hour also cannot get anything. It is difficult, even for myself. Okay? All right. What else do they think about marriage? When are you getting married? Next question. Got girl or not? This one, dangerous. Okay? You see, have, who is she? You say don't have, I'll get you one. You know, so this is a double-edged sword, you know. Say yes, you die, say no, you die. So, okay, now after that, okay. Children, what else do they talk about children?
One more.
I have one more lah. One only, you know. Okay, how many children, okay? How many? One only, you know, so, okay, one more. Okay, there's one more. Okay, what else?
When?
Okay. When? Okay, this one will be very funny, you know. My auntie asked me, when are you children? When? And then I tell them soon now. Oh, but when? I'll call you when I'm doing it. Now, you didn't talk about sex, you didn't talk about anything, but you get it in the past. You know, but your laugh, because it's the truth, it's an anger. You deal with the issue. Stop asking questions. That's the reason why you all laugh. Okay? So we will work on the reason why people laugh. Is because there is a fear, there's an anger. Okay? You get mad. Okay? I get threatened by my aunties a lot because I was very naughty. Okay? So they threaten me. What else? Okay, job. What else do they do?
How much do you make?
How much do you make? Okay? How much? Dollar. Okay. Then what else about job they ask?
Appraisal.
About your appraisal. Okay. Okay. How much is the increment? Auntie, no. How much increment? How much increment?
Bonus.
Bonus. Okay, then bonus. Okay. Enough? No more than that. Okay. Or else you're overboard. Okay. Now, friend, you have a good 3 minutes of comedy here. Okay. If I were to take it, I will build it. I will work backwards. You know. And then afterwards, you try telling a joke, whatever you can, throw it off, simply taro, don't worry about your language, your grammar is correct or not, and see what happened afterward. Can I? Yes, can. Okay, gossiping, what do they gossip?
That auntie,
okay. Other people's son, people's son, okay, or children, I'll tell you. No, this one requires a bit of acting. I think you can. This one I tell you. Indian will go, this one I tell you. Oh, Chinese, I tell you, that man, the son. So, you work on it, okay? Gossip about other people's son. Gossiping. What else?
Neighbors.
You gossip about the neighbors. What do they gossip about the neighbors? Try this one,
Scandal.
Okay. Scandal, affair. Okay, they have scandal. You can have affair. Okay, and you speculate basically. My auntie, everything is an affair. Okay, the opening line, that is a setup. So the scandal is a joke, you know. Everything is an affair. A man coming in and out of my neighbor's house, we're having an affair. A dog coming in and out, what happened? No, that kind of thing. Yeah. So, you just leave it there, you know. What happened? Oh, that kind of woman, you know. So you move on. So you build and you build and you build, okay. So, the next question I've asked you as Toastmaster, okay, gossiping, what else do they gossip? I think, scandal, affair, laundry. Okay, money and all this one. I know our neighbors' laundry. Neighbors, I tell you, they know money. How do you know? I saw the underwear they wore. Every day the same for the last 3 years. Do you do that, huh? Okay. So these are things you can see, yeah? All right. You have a good 3 minutes here, good 3 minutes here. Your problem now is not about writing, it's about deciding what you want to talk about. Okay, boasting. What do they boast?
My son, very successful.
Son. My son, okay? Very well. Thumbs up. My son is doing very well. You know, he's an IT, he's an engineer, da-da-da-da-da-da. Yeah. What else?
My house.
My house. My house.
Vacation.
Okay. But go vacation, okay. Okay, go where for a vacation? So, what else? Now, I'm going to ask you these questions, eh? This thing. Is there a target is there a target here? Who's the target?
Auntie.
Auntie, okay. Would the target, okay, if we have an auntie, that everybody has an auntie? Do we have an hostility against our auntie? Something we angry, sometimes we fearful. We worry when they come over. Yeah, we all, I have that, okay. So, sorry, is it real? Yes. So, the next thing is exaggeration and surprise, and this is how you drop. You can take a picture of this kid, Wiki. Good or not?
Good.
Oh, good, okay. Okay, Wiki. Okay, now you think about it. I'll give you some. Don't have to think about it now. You can always look at this one and see how you want to talk about it. Okay, the topic is very clear. You know, the topic is very clear. It's about nagging, gossiping, and boasting. Okay, and you set it up by having an auntie. So you can always do that. Okay.
So do we? Let's say if I were to craft a 5 to 7 minutes, do I talk about all of this?
I don't answer the question one. I let you draw first, then we decide.
Okay.
Comedy is not about writing, it's about rewriting. Okay, so I also want to think about, I'm so impressed with myself. But again, actually, this is not my work alone. This is a group work. And because we have a group, here, you notice 5 minutes, you come up with a speech. And this is what we do. So you have a speech about this. Next, anybody wants to try? Let's. I've taken a picture.
Yes.
Okay. Don't delete that. Okay. So you have a team? You have. Anybody? Just come. Yeah.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon to you all. My name is Kent from Puchong English Toastmaster Club. Currently, I'm staying in Puchong as well. So what else I need to...
Just keep talking.
Okay, just now you have mentioned you were from Ipoh. It's a gangster town. I kind of agree with you because I have been told that the gangsters are all moving out from Ipoh since long time ago. Moving to Klang, yes, exactly, and also Puchong. Okay. Not yet. Not yet married, and not yet have children. I'm in accounts and finance sector. Okay. What? Topics I would like to do is, usually I would like to do jokes with politics and governments, but as everybody know, topics in government and also politics is kind of a sensitive in Toastmaster speech, and at the same time it's not easy for all the audience to get jokes. Because I noted many of the audience, they don't know sometimes of these government tricks and also the jokes lah. Okay.
Hand. Thank you very much. Shake hand. Okay. Good. His name is Ken. Okay. His surname?
Wong.
Full name?
Jun Kiet.
A lot of Kiet here. Jun Kiet, okay. Okay, what I write down his name is I just want to see whether there's anything funny in the name. Okay? Ken Wong Chun Ket. Okay? Wong Chun Ket. Ken. Ken. K-H-E-A-N. So this is actually, this is very English, American English joke. My name is Kent. American joke. My name is Kent. Wong Chun Ken. One is Kenna, one is Kent, you know. You heard that, huh? My name is Kent. Wong Chun Ken. But this one, you must need someone with good English, lah, huh? You know, huh? Dangerous at this one. You will probably die. Okay, you want to talk about politics? Never mind. Let's work out some clever politics there. Okay, what do you want to do? Okay, what about politics you want to talk about? What area you want to talk about politics? Okay. Let's see if we can clean up for you or not, huh? Enough for Toastmasters. Okay, what else? You want to talk about corruption? Okay. Okay. False promises. Okay. 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 1 MDB is up there. Okay. 1 MDB. Okay. Never mind. You want to talk about it? This one you got to talk about 2.6 lah. Huh? Okay. Okay. So you don't want to be so direct lah. Huh? You talk about the leaders and make it general. You see? Things which can be general, although we think it's only happening in our country, it's happening in every other country. Talk about leaders lah. Okay, we want to talk about leaders. Okay, we want to talk about corruption. We talk about false promises. They say politicians are in a promising career. They promises. Okay. So you want that one? Okay, it's recorded, so it's okay, you can have it. Promising career, okay? Promising career. What else? Come, let's okay, put aside the fear of talking about politics. Let's shoot in general. What is it all about? Okay? Huh? Money. Money comes under? Oh, money. Okay, what about money you want to talk about? What about money you want to talk about? Talk about shopping. Yeah, you talk about shopping. Okay, very nice. You talk about shopping. What else you want to talk about?
Private jet.
Private jet, okay. Luxury. You see? Now, you see, on your own, you think whether you can do or not. But here, you look at it, impossible, isn't it? You talk about luxury, you talk about shopping, you talk about money. Okay. What about leaders? What do we talk about leaders? What are three things you can talk about leaders?
Silly policies.
Okay. Okay. What else?
Leadership.
Never you can use the word lah. Okay. So
blind followers.
Blind followers, yeah. Okay. Okay, what else? What else? Okay, then move on. Okay, false promises. What are the false promises that generally politicians around the world make?
We make the country corruption free.
Huh?
Corruption free.
Make country corruption free. Free. Okay. Now this one we have to do this thing called POW. Okay, you can write it down. This is on the slide. Play on words. Make country corruption free. Okay. In other words, corruption don't cost them any money. Okay. Think about it. Okay, you ready? Okay. Now this one takes too long. You see, the thing is, when it takes too long, comedy should hit you immediately. When I say that, you must ha 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 ha. Gonna be. It sounds very chachak, you know. This thing chachak, you know. So that means it's wrong, okay? Play on words. Okay, what else? Huh? Clean election, huh? Okay. election, clean election, okay. Now, all these are tough topics. Okay, if I want to do it this way, I tell you this way, this is all these things. I want to talk about corruption. It doesn't happen in the country. I want to talk about another country. Okay? They discover there are boxes of ballots that are floating down the river in Iran. Okay, think about it. So this is called association. This technique is called associating with something else, another country. Okay. Now, it's actually quite hard to write, actually, this one, without getting yourself in trouble. Okay. Both Logie and myself, we specialize in political and social communities. So, you want to talk about it, okay, promising career, you can talk. They've been telling us for years, we make all election corruption free. It is an oxymoron. You cannot have an election which is corruption and free. And in fact, that's double oxymoron, you know. So, which one do you want? You want an election, or you want corruption, or you want free? And so, you think about it. So you become education. Okay, this is one topic where in Toastmasters, we'll be finding very hard to work. In fact, for anybody, you need a lot, because, okay, one of the reasons why politics is very hard to work, okay, is this. There are a lot of information about politics and politicians already in the media. For you to top it up to be better than them, it's very difficult. Would you like to try another topic? Okay. Okay. Based on just now the way he talk, what topic you want to give it to him?
Gangster.
Huh? Gangster of Ipoh. Okay, what else? What else?
Accounting.
OT. You talk about your job, talk about your thing. Okay.
Being single.
Being single, you're not married, huh?
Being single, why not? But that would be interesting.
Okay. Personal, okay. Okay, Kent is single. Okay.
Single?
Huh?
Born single.
I don't know who was born double.
Twins.
Okay, twins, okay.
Born married.
There are people who are born married, you know?
Yeah.
Indians will know this. Okay? So it is not a surprise when people born married, Okay? Yeah. Okay, single, let's talk about singlehood, okay? It will be fun. Okay, it will be fun. Ken, why are you single? Why do you think he's single? Okay.
Overqualified.
Okay, what else? Why do you think he's single? Anybody, ladies? Huh? No choice,
No, okay, choice. Okay, choices you have for me? Choice. Huh? Huh?
Boys and girls.
Not sure whether. Not sure whom to choose. Not choice. Okay, boys and girls, okay. Okay then. Boys or girls?
Okay, never mind, we just see where it goes. What else? Overqualified, okay.
Focus too much on number. Focus too much on numbers. On this.
Okay, what else? Would it be funny for you?
No time.
Okay. Okay,
profit and loss. Okay, this one is funny. No money lah, no savings. Okay.
Are you getting married or opening a bank account, you know? No, this is a line, you know, okay? So you can use the line, huh? Are you getting married or opening?
Okay, fine. What else?
Lack of 3 C's.
Huh?
Okay, no time, lack of 3 C's. Lack of 3 C's. Okay, now this one is a bit cliche. Okay, cliche means I've been overused and I've been talked about. Anything better or not? What's the 3 B's? Okay, 3 B's. Okay. Okay, 3 B's. Okay, bungalow. Okay, billion. Anybody can be a billionaire, go to India or Indonesia. Okay, and BMWs. BMWs. Okay.
What else? Okay, which one would you like to hear from him about politics, about his single life? Yeah. Single life, you see? See, huh? So,
and this is what comedy is all about. You want to tell what audience want to hear.
That's why people pay us to tell people what they want to hear. The reason you are here is because you want to hear what you want to hear, to be able to develop this. So, this is going to be fun. Okay, now. Okay, imagine, okay, you write it out, okay, give you 2-3 weeks. Dinesh, we organize another Saturday, we come back over here. We can come over and present it, and then I'll get the evaluator for you. Okay? Okay, this one. See, that's where you are heading. Okay, what else? Overqualified. What is your qualification? A bit of details?
Is
huh?
A degree in accountant. Where do you work?
I work in office. It's like I say, where are you from? Malaysia. Okay. Comedy sometimes involves a little bit of details. And details make it work. You make the subject real. Okay, where do you work? What kind of business are you in?
Property management.
Property management. Degree accountant. Property management. Okay. This one will be funny. I'm a trained accountant. I'm in the property management. And that's why I'm single. Okay? No. Or you say, I am single. Some say because I'm an accountant. And some say because I'm in property management. I think it's both. Okay. So, and as an accountant, I have to weigh on the profit and loss. You know, when I have to weigh whether if I don't have a girlfriend, what will I have? And what happened if I have a girlfriend? What will I lose? Yeah. And you know, my best friend say everything. My father said, it's a good thing that you get married. In other words, they're saying that it's a good thing that I lose everything. Okay. So think about it. Along this track, you build. Now you have good punchlines. Actually, degree in accounting and the property management is right. We do into asset and liability, but don't go into too much of pros and cons. Go into storytelling. You know, I met a girl. I saw her. She was pretty. So I evaluated the asset. In 30 years, will she be pretty? I think so. Not. I saw her mom. Ooh. Think about it. Yeah. Because my father says, if you want to see whether your girl there's a girl you want to marry, look at the mother. I saw the mother. Okay? So this is very, but we attack an issue. We deal with an issue. Think about it. Okay? Boys and girls. Okay, your choice. So this one is going to play on sexuality. Mm-hmm. I have a problem. How old are you now?
40. 40, still not married.
Okay. 40 not married. At 40, if I'm not married, we have 2 problems. Either people think we are poor or something else. Or I'm just gay. Happy. Gay used to mean happy. Do you know gay used to mean happy? Yeah, until you guys mess it up.
So these are things you can talk about already. Actually, a lot of things you can talk about, profit and loss. Okay.
And you must put a story behind it.
set it up. So have you ever met a girl before? How many? Okay. So have you dated anyone before?
Why?
Why do you underqualified?
Underqualified.
Okay, why do you think you are?
Not yet graduate.
Huh?
Not yet graduate.
Not yet graduate.
No degree yet.
Oh, he wants someone with a degree. Confirm ah. Oh, he said he wanted someone with a degree ah. Huh?
Okay. What's his is mine.
Okay. So it's a liability. So God. So, do you know this conversation? We are building a very rich speech for you. Okay, think about the stories. Okay, enough for you. Okay, take a picture of this yourself. You can take a picture. It's yours. You can easily develop into good 3 to 3 minutes, 3.5 minutes of comedy here. Hmm? Why BMW? Because they like BMW. See? Okay. So, why BMW? I must tell you a story about BMW. Today, everybody drives BMW. About 40 years ago, when I was in Ipoh, if you see someone driving a BMW, you got a problem, you know. If you see a Chinese driving a BMW, sure, it's a pimp. You see a Malay driving a BMW, must be Ahmad, a driver. You see an Indian driving a BMW, car jockey. You see a Punjabi driving a BMW, car repossessor. There was an old line we did a long time, which is true. In Ipoh, when we see a woman driving a BMW, those days, in the 70s, usually it's someone's mistress. Okay? Usually. That's what we always speculate. So it was true then. It works then, but it doesn't work now. Okay? So you must use context. Okay? I know it's insulting, but comedy, that is how we insult people and laugh about it. Okay? Sometimes you do that. Try not to. Okay. Now, next person. Okay, ladies, any ladies? Yeah. Who wants to go? Huh? Okay.
Hello. Hi, my name is Jolene. I'm from MII Toastmasters. I actually have a topic in my mind, but I'm not sure how to structure it properly.
Just tell the topic.
Talk about the topic. Wait, the topic is about my niece. I'm a big fan of my niece because she has this grumpy cat look. She has this naturally what the heck eyes and a downturn mouth. But I have like a lot of jokes about her, but I don't know how to structure it in a way that to make it meaningful, the speech meaningful. Okay, let's say for example, one day, my sister, her friend, and my niece came to my house. So, my niece suddenly threw the medicine at my sister's friend. Then my sister got angry and said, "Say sorry." And then my niece said, "Sorry." And then after that, my sister said, "Say sorry to who?" Yeah, my sister said, "Sorry, medicine." Kind of thing. Yeah, I don't know how to make it meaningful. Like, also, there's another time while I was doing my eye makeup, I was like thinking, wow, I look hot, wow, I look great. My niece came in and she said, "Ee, why are you doing the zombie?" That kind of thing, yeah. But how do I make it meaningful? I mean, like, how do I structure it?
How old are you?
27.
Okay, hello. I'm not just being doing it, but just get a bit
of
detail.
Okay.
Married?
No.
How many sisters in the family do you have?
Only one sister.
Okay.
Younger sister.
Okay, she's married. Parents. Where are you from?
Fuchong.
Hi,
Fuchong.
Okay. Jolene. Okay. I think Jolene's... Okay. You see how we can help you on that one?
Okay.
Tell us just one more story about your niece.
These are the two significant ones I can remember. I think that's all for now. I can't think of any.
Angry or what would you think of your niece?
Very adorable.
She's adorable.
Yeah. brutally honest.
Brutally honest.
Yeah, brutally honest.
Does she know that she's brutally honest?
I don't think she knows that. I think she's just being truthful.
How old is she?
3 years old this year.
3 years old, so she has that innocence about
her. Very cute.
So do you want her to carry on like that?
Yeah, of course.
Alright. Anybody any question for her? You all know where this is heading already, so you all can start asking questions. Ask her.
Do you admire that in her?
Yeah,
right. Would you like to do that?
Yeah, I like to be brutally honest to people.
Do you find that in your daily life, you want to be as brutally honest as her? Okay, in what situation would you want to do that?
I think you need to lose weight.
Oh, okay. So I said that out loud.
Okay.
Must be from Penang or Kedah. Okay.
J-O-L-Y-N-N.
Y-N-N. Okay, one N not enough, must be double N. Jolene. Okay, okay. What else? Chen.
H-U-I-L-I-N.
Okay. Sometimes names is one of the best ways to get people to like you is you take a light look at your own name. You know, like Logendron would say, "Hey, my name is Logendron." Some people call me the Prince of the Universe. So that's the meaning, you know. Huilin, what does it mean, you know? All Chinese names mean something. Like me, my Chinese name is Man Wen Tao. My Chinese name is Wen Tao. It means someone who knows everything. But that's not what my wife thinks. You see, it's funny, isn't it? So you make fun of it and take a light look at your own name, you know. So my name is very hard to write one. So, okay. Do you think the story of telling about your niece will be funny to you all? Huh? Okay. Now, let's go back to the chart. Okay, let's go back to the chart. Was there a target? If you target, was the niece a good target? Okay. Is young children a good target or not? Not a good target. Not a good target usually. Because children tend to be very adorable. We accept them to be what who they are. So sometimes it may not be funny. Okay, what else? Is there any hostility against your niece? No. See, without that, first two is gone. Even if the story is real, then the first two is gone. Now nevertheless, having said that, let's pick up the nuggets from there. She call you a zombie. Okay? She call you a zombie. What else? She told you to lose weight. What did she tell you? Okay? So, this one. Storytelling in a speech contest very difficult because you will find it very difficult. I will find it very difficult to write. Good story, okay, we'll keep it. So, based on you seeing her, the way she speaks, what do you think would be a good topic for her? Huh?
She actually did a good speech last year. She did a great speech in feminism.
Okay. That's last year. So this year, we have 7 topics for you to choose from. Feminism, it will be under one of the topic, of course, and the arts and culture. Yeah, and a family side. What else?
Being single.
Again, being single. Wow, you all are serious about singlehood, huh? Okay. What do you do for a living? Oh, teacher! Wonderful! Okay. Being a teacher, you're seated right. What did I do? Okay. Being a teacher, you're seated right in the midst of it, okay? You do this. You have zombies, you have scary movies, Friday the 13th, okay? You can always begin with this, okay? Friday the 13th, horror movies, okay? Okay, how many of you have watched Friday the 13th? How many of you like, anyone of you like horror movies? I don't know about you, I live in one. I'm a teacher, you know. So, is that a horror sometimes? As a teacher, is it a horror movie for you sometimes? You being a teacher? You really enjoy it? I mean, I'm sure you enjoy your job, but are there moments that you don't want to talk about? If I were to, you want to think about singlehood, you think about arts, she's a teacher. Okay. Let me see. If I were to give you a topic, what do you think? She's, okay, let me tell you what she is now, as I see it. She is pretty. She is 27 years old. She is a teacher. She likes kids, which happens to be, she likes kids. And she wants to tell a funny story. What are you going to write for her? Guys? Okay. Importance of birth control. Okay. What else? Okay. No, let's look at it. Where do you want to go for it? Anybody there? She's pretty. That is a half better one. That you don't have to do anything. The boys will start looking at her. Teacher, so pretty one. A face like this, you need help. Not a face like this, you need help. Okay. Feminism is gone. What will be something close to your heart? Okay. All right. I think I got an idea. Let's personalize your story, your niece one. Let's see how it works. And this is a lot of storytelling, okay, style of comedy. You begin with yourself, talk about yourself. I like to do makeup. I drew my eyes and I thought I was pretty until my niece came along and she said, "Auntie, why you look like a zombie?" Yeah? And kids, they explain already why you look like a zombie. Then I put on my lipstick, why your mouth looks like chili. So things like that. You personalize the story. So then if a 3-year-old can tell me what's wrong with me, how can I look pretty? Maybe you talk about how I look pretty. Or do I think I'm fat? Okay, we come back to you one moment. We are stuck here, that for sure. We are stuck, definitely we are stuck for her. Okay, so it doesn't matter.
Do you think it's hard for
females
to be funny?
No. I don't think so. Just that, okay. For a female, if you want to talk about feminism, it could be good, okay? And now, one of the reasons people laugh is because they know you. So in the Toastmasters, you can talk about anything because most of them, at least 30% knows you. That's all you need to get people to laugh. If 20-30% laugh for you, the rest will laugh along because they don't know why.
What about analyzing a guy whether he's a boyfriend material?
Have you ever done that?
My friend, okay.
You can begin. My name is. Hi, I'm Jolene. I'm 27. I'm at the age when all my aunties asking me, am I married? And I have to do something about it. So I start looking at the right material. This is what I look for. So you talk about, okay, let's look about guys. Why is a guy, okay, that means, if you're looking for who can be my boyfriend or to be my husband, okay, boyfriend is easy, to be a husband material harder. Okay, so what do you think she will be looking for? What is the pros and what will be the cons? What is she not looking for? Okay, what is she looking for to be a boy, a husband?
Babies,
okay. Healthy sperm. That will be funny. Okay.
Good gene, good gene.
No, no, it's good. First thing is, so okay. Now 3 B's is common now. Stay away from the 3 B's. I know you wonder whether I'm looking for money, car, bungalow, all those things. No, the first thing is I look for healthy genes, healthy sperm. Straight to the point. Okay, Toastmasters. Okay, now this one. Any judges here? Okay, did they say? Sperm is not a swear word, you know. Okay, never mind. Okay, don't think whether it's right or wrong first. Let's write it down right now. Okay, first thing, healthy sperm. Okay, why? How do you know it's a healthy sperm or not?
How does it look?
Look at the future father-in-law, lah. Huh? Father-in-law, huh? What else? What was it? You say something? No, no. Sorry, lah. Okay, look at the father-in-law first, not even the husband, you know. Okay, but see the father-in-law. Okay. We make fun of girls, guys, we look for wife, we look at the mother, the future mother-in-law. So, now, we look at the future father-in-law. I saw my father, there was one boy who was interested in me. So, he took me to, I said, can I have a picture of your father? You look at it, tummy too big, cannot, because that's what it will be. You know, so I saw the future final, tummy too big, the face too round, and too much hair. So you don't know. So this is, look at future father-in-law. You build. Okay, what else? Go ahead.
Because there's a very old Chinese saying, you look for a girl, whether she can give you a lot of children, you look at the back, right?
The hip.
The hip.
Yes.
Okay. So maybe you do
something
for the guys as well.
Okay. What do you do if we see whether the guy is healthy or not? Huh? Big nose. Some say look at his nose, okay. Okay, never mind. No, it's funny. Okay, let's move back. He said look at his nose. And I went to, you know, I look at his nose. Okay, fine. Now, we don't think whether it's funny or not. What else? Whether this guy got healthy sperm or not, look at his nose. What else? Okay. Now this is what you call we have double meaning here. A lot of double meaning here. When you say looking, double meaning is funny. Okay. Half the jokes. Many years ago when we did a comedy show, and before even we hit the punchline, people laugh. So we asked those people, why you laugh? Oh, because we saw the finished picture in our mind. And they saw something else, which is totally different from what we have in mind. So comedy is like that. We take you one way, let you finish one way, and end up this way. So okay, fine.
How do you make it double meaning?
Double meaning. Okay. Okay. Look at the nose. Okay. Go and search internet lah.
How many girlfriends he had before?
Okay. 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 So his past, okay, the past, okay, his past, okay, how many girlfriend? Okay, how many girlfriend, huh?
The satisfaction.
Okay, how many girlfriend? So, why is it important to you? Okay, he cannot be too cheap, okay. I must see how many girlfriends he has, because I don't want him to be too cheap. Okay, cheap, okay. So how do you know he's cheap?
Easily fall for girls.
Huh? Easily fall for girls. Okay, easily fall for girls. That's a good line. I don't want my boyfriend to be like a movie special. You know, it's a good line, like a movie special. Easily fall for girls, movie special, you know? Okay. You want a movie special? Someone who's movie special.
Movie special, okay? Okay.
Okay.
Well, okay. It was he my enemy boyfriend before? Okay. Okay. Okay, yeah.
Was it important? No. That means someone you hate, that. This boy is also your enemy's boyfriend before. Would it be important for you? Never mind, put it there first. That's the matter. What else?
Boyfriend.
Yeah, your girl, your... Oh, this one has to think, huh? That means not funny already. No, seriously. It is like that one, huh? Okay, what else? Anything? Anything?
Any bad habits? Okay, habits, okay. What are the bad habits that you have to worry about for your future husband?
Snoring too loud. Snoring too loud.
Okay, doesn't brush his teeth.
Hygiene.
Brush, okay. He brush his teeth. Hygiene, but brush his teeth lah. Snoring, okay. Okay, how many of you snore here?
Many.
Huh?
You snore, okay.
Too many, our life shoulders. Terrible.
I disagree with my wife because I told her I never heard of it before. That is a good line. You can use it. You know, people say that I snore. I disagree with my wife. I say I didn't hear it. You know, and you do that, you know, you must do an action. I didn't hear it. You know. So, okay. What else? Snoring. What else? Brush teeth. Snoring. Got it. Okay. Is a good job important for you? Okay, anyway, it's enough for you to build about 3 minutes here only. You think about it, take a picture of it, and then see if you work on it. Okay? Are you all tired?
No.
No, good, okay. Next. Take a picture. Come, Nick, come nearer, take it, it's okay, man. Huh? Because I don't know what camera you have, mine on this close. Okay, Samsung. You know, what we have here are actually materials that any one of you can use, okay? So don't worry about it, about who use what materials, because comedy is nothing original. If you talk about family, most of us are married. You talk about politics, arts, all of us have done it before. So what I'm sharing with you today is not mine as well, because someone has done it before. So you can choose any of these because you're from different club. Okay, hey, by the way, secret. Secret for you. If you copy all this down, you have at least, if you win the club level, you have another area level to go. So you have about 4 or 5 speeches writing here today. So you can have a lot of speeches for you. This thing does not apply to her alone, also to apply to you all, some of these.
Does it apply to me?
What? No, it can be very funny if a man. When I start, you know, when I met my wife, my future wife, she brought me to see my father-in-law, my future father-in-law. You know, the first question he asked me is, he asked me, how many brothers and sisters you have? I said, including me, 4. And then he asked me, how many brothers and sisters your father has? I said, 7. And then how many brothers and sisters your father's father, your grandfather had? I said, about 12. I said, good pedigree, okay. Does it work for you? Same thing, tell story differently. See, yeah? So you can personalize the whole thing and make it very fun. So now, what else could be funny? Listen, I talk about the snoring, you know? I told you the snoring joke already. My wife said, I snored. I disagreed. I said, never heard about it before. Okay, the other one you can be funny will be, people ask me, are you married? I say, yes. How many children you have? Depends whom you ask. My wife say 3. Okay. Okay, huh? Very fast, this one, huh? Okay, here's the one. People ask me how many children I have. Depends on whom you ask, lah, you know. You ask me, I say 2. You ask my wife, she say 3. So what else can you? Okay, you see, I am not a cheap man. Whether it apply to you or not, I'm not a cheap man. when my wife was interested in me, she asked me, have you had any girlfriend before? I said, what do you think I am? I'm not the kind of guy. I am like special premier, movie special. Only special people can help me. You. See, it all can be play around and you turn it and become yours. Comedy is not about writing, it's about rewriting. Okay? So you by now you know more where I'm heading. Okay, next person.
Okay.
I need to introduce myself, right?
Okay, hi. They can ask you questions. Feel free to ask you questions.
Okay.
You lost here or you shaved yourself?
I lost and shaved. Okay, hi. I'm Tiago from Bangsa Toastmasters Club, and I have no topics yet, but I want to talk about education. talk about education. Okay, I work in oil and gas. Whenever I go out, introduce myself as oil and gas professional, people ask, is there any job in a company? Or another thing people will ask is, what do you suggest me to study? The elders will ask. Then, recently I encountered, Mark Zuckerberg was awarded doctorate. Mark Zuckerberg.
Okay.
But anyone can guess what his doctorate is about? His doctorate is in law. The guy was doing in computer science and he was awarded. So I want to talk on those line of education. How the we don't need to study so hard. As long as study to think is good enough. Probably it's a serious topic, I think. Nobody's laughing.
That's what we're here for. We see how we can make it funny.
Even
for someone that's tough as Jolene.
Okay.
No, seriously. Okay.
Yeah. And
any question for him? Ask him anything you want. Your questions will help him build his topic.
Why need? You need further details?
Do you feel more than
shaving? Ask him any question.
Okay. Oh, it's very nice. During Taipusam, people ask me, is it for, do you shave for religious thing or not? No, it's always. My response is,
I'm always religious.
always religious.
Okay,
okay,
good. Thank you. What's the name again?
Tiago.
Tiago. Okay. Okay, your name? Okay. At least he knows how to spell. Tiago. 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 Okay. Is that your full name?
Yeah, that's only my name.
My name. The rest belongs to your father lah. Okay, the rest, don't take it belongs to Vivek, you know. It's recorded also, belongs to him. Okay. Tiago. Okay, analaki you da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay. It could be very funny, you get start lah. My name is Tiago and analaki da-da-da-da. But many people call me Botak. Okay? But my friends call me Botak, you know. So okay. Okay, good. I don't. Tiago, what? Where's it? I tell people. Hello. Okay, go again. Say, my name is Tiago. Some people say, Diego Maradona, Diego? No. Tiago. Indian, Tiago, anak lelaki. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So, but you have to do it with a bit of force, a bit of anger, a bit of your style. Okay. You notice what are the questions asked just now about you? Your hair. Is it more masculine? So, between education and his botakness, which one do you all like to hear? Okay. So it's very clear, isn't it? You see, in this workshop, okay, guys, okay, in this workshop, you can see what audience want to hear from you. Now, this one you won't know in the Toastmasters Club or in any other place when you perform. Either you're funny, you kill, or you bomb. But here, you know straight away. This is what you want to be. So, now they want to talk about your botakness. okay? No, I know what you are looking at, okay? I am bored, okay? I know my friend always, my Chinese friend also asked me, still Thai Pusam ah? You know? You do it very nice, you know? My Chinese friend all asked me, still Thai Pusam ah? No, I said that's a few months ago. Then why your hair? You know, what happened, you know? Yeah, so that is one area you can look at. Afterwards, do you need a 5 minute break for your shishi break? Yeah, are you okay, yeah? Okay, before we continue on, let's stand up and do, what you call an energizer first. Okay, so that you can, let's do a laughter. Okay, do a laughter. This is something me and Logie started in 2000. In the year 2000, we did a laughter workshop, okay? All right, let's do a teh tarik laughter. Okay, teh tarik, how we do it? Yeah, you let's do. And let's put it. So when you have teh tarik, you have teh tolak also, isn't it? Ah, you do this. One more time. And then, of course, there is the lion laughter. You go. One more time. Okay, this is the very cold country, Scandinavia, very cold. They have this called 1 inch laughter. Okay. Yeah, when we are in springtime, we have a 1 meter laughter. Okay, ready? Okay, put the camera again. Okay, thank you very much. Sit down again. Okay. Okay. All right, Tiago, we want to know about your hair. Masculine. What do you want to know about Tiago? Guys, his hair? Huh? He got botak, it means healthy sperm. That's why it's botak. Maybe, okay. Never mind. Okay.
Male, okay, botak because, okay, Thai Pusam is one you can talk about. We talk about Thai Pusam.
I know. People look at my hair. Your music, you must dance. Relax, chill, man, chill. Okay, this is fun now. Okay, you know, you come out, the moment you do it, okay, the moment you come out, I know what you're thinking. Now it's June. My Chinese friend asked me, still Thai Pusam, ah? You know, okay? And look at the hair, you know? Say, you do this, still Thai Pusam, ah? You know? So let's see where it goes. You can try that one. Okay, the other one is, okay, you talk about. They said, why are you bald? I thought Indians are hairy. I did my research. Okay.
Why am I bald? Okay, why I am bald? I just use short languages. Indian are all hairy one. Indian hairy. Okay?
Then you can always throw a curveball there. I did my research. Apparently my male testosterone are shooting way too high. That's why the hair has to come out. Okay, yeah? Think about it. Hey, this is the material for you, you can try, okay?
Male testosterone. The testosterone, okay. The testosterone. So I'm thinking about.
You find it out, then you Google it.
Where to spell, okay.
Obviously, I don't have it a lot because my hair is. I have hair, okay. So, see, okay. So, what else do you want to know? Guys? This is only a good 1 minute, only, yeah? You know, but it's botak. What else do you want to know? Okay. Now, you say botak, you know, okay, you talk about how his hobbies.
What?
Okay. hobbies. They ask me, hey, you botak, you hit the ball painful. Okay, you ask this question.
Okay, heading, football. Would it be funny? Football, heading, okay.
Okay. I tell them I don't play football. I play badminton, you know, something like that. Or something totally different. Okay. I do kabaddi. Huh? Okay, I go to hotel. Hotel. They got hair conditioner.
Okay. Hair conditioner in hotel. Okay.
Okay, what else? What would be funny, yeah? When you are bald and you have facial hair, do you go to the barber to shave your face? So what do you do? What do you think it will be funny? Okay, what else?
Now, you only have about 2 minutes plus of comedy here only.
Yes, Vivek.
So when he goes to the barber, this is a true story actually. Because my dad is bald. His haircut is more expensive than mine because they charge him a searching fee.
Searching fee?
Okay, barber. More expensive? Charging search fee.
Now, why this will be a very funny comedy is because you're talking about yourself, you're making fun of yourself. You can't go wrong. When you make fun of yourself, okay, but what else? Are you married? Okay.
Not married. Any girlfriend? Not yet.
Okay.
Do you have children?
Okay. Like children. Children don't like him, okay? Okay.
I like children, but children don't like me. Okay, what else? Okay? Any more?
Less air resistance.
Okay, under hobby, yeah?
Or racing.
You do racing, bike riding, yeah?
Yeah.
Motorbike or bicycle? Huh? You wear helmet, what? But cycle, you also wear helmet on. Okay. Running. Okay.
You are good. Stop by police, huh? By police. Okay. No.
I was running.
Okay. I'm Indian. I'm bored and I was running. I stopped by police. The police asked me, "What are you doing?" I'm running.
You think you're bored, you can run faster. You know, something like that. You just better build up.
No, I have one more line you say.
So I was stopped by police. You know? When you're bored and you cannot run, you know? Okay.
So I was jogging and all those things. Think about it. Stop by police. It will be funny.
You will think it will be funny. Okay. But you guys can also take this one and use it for yourself. Mix and match and turn it around. Okay. Now, with this kind of information here, just for the fun of it, would any one of you dare to come in and do an impromptu 1 minute here? You want to do an impromptu? On this? Yes. Just choose anything and talk about it, okay? Feel free. Okay. Now, whoever's going to come and do an impromptu on this, okay, you all will benefit from here, okay? So much stuff.
On this?
Just on this. Just pick one here. Okay. Anyone? You want to go to one?
Yeah.
Anything. Just talk about it. Remember the spider? Start putting ideas down even though ridiculous. Okay? Don't worry about it whether it's right or wrong. What's stopping us is because we want to be right or wrong. Just put it down first and see where it goes. Where it goes. Okay? Right? I must drink water first. Okay. Anyone want to try? You want to try? Anyone? Let's help Tiago come. Keith, you want to try? Come, Keith.
Three.
Afterward, don't worry. Okay, come.
Okay, you give us 1 minute. Okay, say Tommy, man. Wow, 1 or 2 minutes. Anything, man, you just talk, I think we're gonna talk.
Hi, everyone. I'm Keith.
I'm Malaysian. Ethnically, I'm Chinese. Guys sometimes get interested in me because they look at my skin is very smooth. They put their hand on my hand and they will just rub off because I'm so smooth. Compared to my friend, Tiago, he's very hairy, right? He's Indian. He's got hair everywhere from the bottom, legs, all the way to top, except it stops here. So everyone thinks that it's hypusum for him because his hair is bald all the time. And he goes to hotel and he has hair conditioner. I end up using all of them because he doesn't need them, really. What else have we got here?
Okay.
That's it, that's all I have.
All right, okay. Thank you.
There's a good 30 seconds you can use that. Okay. It's recorded, so I sent it to you all. Let's hope the recording is amazing. It's okay. It will be private to you all. Okay, and me. We shall send share the whole world. No, la. Okay, what else? Who else want to try? Huh? No. No? Just talk about it, anything.
Hi, good afternoon everyone, my name is Belinda. So you see this hair of mine? It's so thin and so fine. So one day I told my business partner, I want to shave my hair. And then they told me, you'll definitely look like E.T. Because why I want to shave my hair is so I can save on hair shampoo and conditioner. And maybe I can regrow more hairs, better hairs, who knows?
We can adjust this one for you.
No, I just want to see the material here.
Okay, give me the material. Sorry guys, the other side.
Okay, hi everyone. I'm Sri. I stay very nearby the airport in New Delhi. I have a friend. He's my best buddy. And he makes me look handsome because I have hair. He doesn't. When we ride our motorbike, when police catches us, I'm wearing helmet. He doesn't. And when police asks him why, he says, I got natural one. Why I should buy another one? There is a problem when we go to temples. When I hear a coconut broken, I worry. I look at my friend. I'm glad you're still safe, my bro. Because I worry somebody might break him himself considering a coconut. Once upon a time, we went to the zoo. As we walked in, all the children started screaming. I don't see anything scary. Then suddenly I realize that they thought an alien came. That's it.
Okay, there are a few gems there. Okay, a few gems there. smoothness, you know. You know, you talk about Jesus. I'm Indian. Naturally, we are hairy. Mine is like coconut tree. Grow all the way and stop right here only. You know, or something like that. It's just stop here, it will not grow anymore. Okay. So, that's the thing about it. That's one you can borrow from him. Yours is the hair is fine. Well, okay. Some people, my friend was very fine hair. I'm finding my hair. Okay, yeah? So this is called reversal. This technique is called reversal. Okay. What else? Now, just how you said that. You know, I went with my friend who looks like a gorilla and up to the zoo. And the kids saw us, you know. And they start screaming. I told my friend to go away. And you know, my friend left. They are still screaming. It was me, you know. They get the kind of thing. So this one needs a bit of action. Need to work on. Whether you're comfortable. What else did he say?
Okay, bought a bike. Yeah, the bought a bike. You know. You know, people need to buy a helmet. I just need to draw on it. Okay, you think about it. You just draw on it, you know. You draw a line here. You know? Okay, just think about it. Okay, this one. Because I have a lot of art space. Okay. Kids like my hair, okay? My nephew likes my head because when they are naughty, I just give them a pen to draw on. So they decorate my hair. So think about it, you know. This is a playground for my kids. You take care of kids, they have to run around. No. All I need is a dust, is a what we call a marker and a duster. You know, just write and then just cut, and then draw again. Kids have a good time. So, you see? So you have about 3.5-4 minutes of comedy there. You know, you develop from there. I know you want to talk about education. Education is not something easy to talk about, huh? Because a lot of anger over it. So you want to talk about people asking you, okay, the other area you just talk about is people want to ask me about what job to do. Now, this is common to all of us. Let's talk about a common topic for all. Then we move on to the next person. Very common topic people ask us when you go. First question I ask you, when they don't see you for a long time, okay, what job you do? Okay, this is the auntie story, yeah? What job you do? What else did they ask you? How much you make? How much you make? Money, lah. Then, got job, ah. You know, these are very common questions. You can use it for anything. This one is very common. Any one of these. Once you are working, people always ask you, and then you are driving a big car, your somebody will ask you, hey, your company got job, ah? Well, I'm in oil and gas. Now think of what is also oil and gas besides kitchen. Okay, no, seriously, think about it. I said I'm in oil and gas. What do you do? I'm a chef. Huh? What's it? Petrol station, not likely lah. You know, must be real lah. Because you guys will never be a petrol station attendant. You have to be Bangladeshi. So the reality is that the joke doesn't match your job, no ma. But you say, okay, I'm also in oil and gas, I'm a chef. Okay. Would it be possible? What else? What other oil and gas? What other jobs you do got oil and gas one? Your hand can go like that one. Huh? Yeah. His head totally inverted like that one. So I thought, what alien movie I'm looking at? No. Really, until here. See. Something wrong, this one. Okay. Okay, what else? So, jobs will be very common. Can introduce or not, you know, introduce a job. These are very common things that you get, okay? Think about an alternative answer. Very common, huh? Okay. Besides, oh, I guess I'm a teacher. Okay, teacher. Once you say you're a teacher, nobody asks you any question, man. They think teacher are low pay, long hours, and are not rewarding. Okay, parents nowadays don't look for teachers. You see, you say they are nurse. You want people to stop asking you a question, just say, I'm a nurse. Nobody asks you any more question. Okay, so let's see what I do. So, okay. Next person. Yes, come.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kang. I'm a preschool teacher. And the topic that I'm interested in is in education. If not, then is the complaints being a housewife. Not well paid, not recognized, even though we are contributing to the GDP. Actually, I preferred education, but since if you can help to develop one, that would be good. Actually, I deal a lot with children, preschool, and actually in preschool setting, we have to do everything. We have to be the nanny, cleaning up the mess. We have to sing. We have to dance. We have to joke around, everything under the sun, and yet the pay is so tiny, tiny.
And compared to being a housewife, it's not the same.
As a preschool, doing half-day job, at least I get a bit of pay, but being a housewife in the house, I do still get a pay, but I don't get the official recognition. There's no career progression. You don't get appraisal. Yeah, you do get appraisal every now and then. But you don't get increment unless you really fight over it. And I think I have only two kids. That is none of my business. So long end of the day, he pays me the pay for the household. It's a hobby. I love to watch drama, and I can spend throughout the night watching drama.
What drama do you like to watch?
Korean drama, Chinese traditional drama. Come again? Yeah, at times we watch that together, and in Cantonese they call me I'm the Sun Yu.
It's okay, don't worry. The mic will pick up. It's okay.
I'm the Sun Yu, so called the bad influence. Actually, both my children, they are going for SPM and PT3, and yet they were sitting with me
watching the
drama together. It's a challenge for me to work on humorous speech because by nature, I'm the elder of the family, and I'm a preschool teacher, and before this, I was actually a banker. So all the way, I am seen as someone who is very serious. Oh, no. I love children, and they love me.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
How do you make them listen to you?
Because I'm the one who can joke around, play around. I can give them the hard time and the sweet time.
Thank you. Captain Scott, preschool, wife, banker. Okay. Which of these three topics would have a bigger, better target?
Housewife. Housewife would be a better target.
Why?
Because you're housewife yourself. Okay. Now, ladies, she say housewife. Guys, who else is say? Who says housewife is a bigger target? Hands up. Okay.
Preschool teacher. Okay.
All right.
So banker, not what?
Okay. Now, one of the things she said was, I was a banker, then I become a preschooler. I have a career progression. I was a banker, now I'm a preschooler. Preschool teacher. That is a line for you. You can write that down if you want to. So, what else? Okay. Ken. With a T. Ken. Anything? Okay. You think housewife is the whole thing? Okay, let's talk about housewife.
Okay, housewife.
What's the issue about housewife we're gonna talk about?
Long hours. And appreciation. Okay. What else?
Attention.
Appreciation. Same. Attention. Okay. What else? Experience, what experience? A housewife is a job without?
Without experience.
Without experience?
On the job, you learn on the job.
Without stand? Without experience, okay.
Okay. Now, I'm Kang. Let's say, Kang is going to present this huge stand-up comedy. Who is the target? You are going to be a judge. Who is the audience? Who should be the target?
Fellow mothers.
Fellow mothers are target.
Husband.
People with kids. Okay. Husband. Well, now, before we even continue with this, we have to find out who is the target. Some say husband. Should it be herself as a target? No lah. Community, not too wide. The target must be agreeable by all. Okay, who says husband is the target? 1, 2, 3. The family is the target. Would it be funny if you target your family? Okay, so the target is the husband and family. Okay.
long hours.
Huh?
Yes, sir. I don't know. Okay, let's start building the whole thing. Okay, what about long hours you will talk about?
24/7.
Okay, we'll talk about 24/7 compared to what? You see, you when you look at this, you must be hostility. Long hours. Okay, the target is a family. It's long hours. Okay. What else? What will be the thing? Rain, getting tired, isn't it? Yeah, I understand. It is. Normally, at this time, me and Logi will be having a coffee. okay. Normally, we walk around, we talk a lot. We both of us talk a lot. We can talk for 3-4 hours. Yeah. And we don't get tired until we get home. And then our wife asks us, why are we so tired and quiet? Okay. All right. Appreciation. Deal with housewife. Okay, what are the stories about housewife, Linda? Huh? No idea. Okay. Okay. So you are... If I were to do it, I would look at all these things together. Okay. Okay, what happens if the judges are all male when you say the husbands are annoying? Speech contest, ma. When you attack the wrong person, and Dinesh is saying, what? You're saying me, I'm not married. Oh, they say, what? You're talking about men? Oh, by the way, I'm not married. Okay, so, you can talk about career progression, okay? You can talk about your career progression, Or you can talk about general things that is happening. I like the news in the guy who's, when London was attacked. When they went into this pub and this guy said, I am Millwall! Now the guy who fall off the attacker is it? And they said they are, I am here for God, they are there for Millwall, the guy. So that kind of thing, we have looked at something to build up the whole thing and attack the situation. I have, you can talk about career progression. Okay, talk about career progression. Okay, I started my life as a banker and now I'm a preschooler. It's funny. Preschool teacher. What else is funny? Okay. Huh? Okay. Okay. Play with money. Okay.
Now I play for money.
Okay. Play with money. Yeah. You see? Now you play for money. So you use it before last time story. Okay. Play. We are getting somewhere. Come on. Okay. Play for money. Okay. Okay. What else? What do you do as a banker? When I was banker, I count other people's money, okay? People money, okay, yeah? Now I count on people for money. Count on people for money, okay? Now this is only 30 seconds for money. The setup is not there.
So, you talk about, basically you're talking about your life, I have a great life, okay?
I can move from this and this. What else? From banker to because then, again, what else? What else is funny? Now, you also have to look at audience, okay? You see? Bankers, what else? You have a great punchline here, This is a good one. For money, just, okay. You cannot do more than 3. This one will be one more will do for this one. This is called reversals and play on money and all those things, I find my hair is happening. So what else? Next area. We go to the next area. When you are, so then now, and then I'm from preschooler. Now I'm a housewife. You can say I like kids. I like kids. Okay. I can't say the same for them. Can't say the same for them. Okay. For them. I hope all these are recorded. I don't know whether it's going to hang or not. Okay. For you. Okay, what else?
What else? You like kids, yeah? What do you do with the kids? Okay, what do you do with the money in the bank? What else do you do in the bank? Okay, last time, smell. Last time, smell comes from money. Comes from money, but smell comes from money. Sometimes you get all sorts of people's money, ma. Huh? Now I just got smell, you know. Okay. So what about else? Will it be the kids? Kids smell. Okay, whatever. I don't know. What else? You're not married, huh? Okay. But you are not suitable for him. Okay. So you're Well, last time I was Last time I was underqualified for my job. What about you? You have a degree, isn't it? And you are a bank officer. Okay, you are underqualified for my job, okay? Underqualified, just say that. Last time I was underqualified for my job. Okay? For job. Now I'm overqualified. Maybe? Think about it. Why do you leave the bank?
Because of my children.
Okay, how to make that one funny? I quit my job for my kids. Okay, then you work in a preschool. What will be so funny about that? But there's no target, no hostility there. Okay, you know you cannot sense the anger there. So when you hear that, I didn't see any anger, I didn't see any problem there. Yeah.
I couldn't fix my kids, but
good one, good one. Okay, let's work backwards, huh? Okay, this is very good. This is very good. I love it. Quit for my kids. Yeah. I realized I cannot fix them. Cannot fix them. Fix them. So I fix other kids. Okay. Other people's kids are other kids. Is it? Then I realize other people's kids are better than mine.
And I can pay for it.
Yeah, it's funny. It is really funny. And then I can't pay for it. This one I worked so hard and pay for it. It's okay. How come I never get this manual? How come my mom never tells me this when I got married, you know? Before I got married. No, seriously, it is an insight, you know? Suddenly, it's a dawn of realization. People say, oh, this is true, huh? And then you're angry. What is this? And then, of course, you add a bit of action. Just tell the story. Now, don't try to explain. In humor, one of the biggest error we all try to do is try to explain. Because of this. No, cut off the because. Build the whole thing into that. So what you do now is you go back and write this, take a picture, and write this. In a couple of weeks, if we can, we will run through it, and we evaluate it, and we help you to compact it. See? You see, yeah? Now, here's the interesting thing. I always love to do this, this workshop is because you never know what will come out. And when you put people together, today, we have read 5 speeches already. Okay, now these 5, any one of 18 of you, any one of you can take any of these 5, mix and match, and become your speech. Don't underestimate. Just because I wrote for one person, okay, that doesn't mean it's not for you. Because here is the funny thing is this. The principle that of life, the things that goes wrong, and you match your story into it, and it become your story, and everybody else, sorry. Okay.
Next, anybody who wants to try, I can do two more before we finish up today. Okay, introduce yourself, tell a bit about yourself.
Okay. Yeah.
Good afternoon. Right, you are right. We are towards the evening. My name is Manish Jha. You can still call me MJ. May not be Michael Jackson. I love doctors. But I'm an engineer.
Is anyone right? This from far is okay.
In my life, I met few doctors. When I was small, my grandmother took me to the hospital and I went to the dentist for the first time. And she asked me, she was scared, not me. Then she called my grandmother, why he is behaving like this, making extra sound. Then my grandmother came inside and said, she is saying, open your mouth. Then I opened my mouth. Again, she's asking, And then she injected two injections inside my mouth to extract my teeth from both the sides. It was painful. But then, doctor was so beautiful. I was not really that in the pain. Next time, when I grown up, I went to another doctor. And this time, I had the problem with my hearing. And this is the incident of Malaysia. Somebody suggested me to meet a Chinese doctor. And I went there. I was very much in pain. It was really, really unbearable. He was looking like, sit. What's your problem? I cannot hear. Then he said, okay. I said, I have pain in my hearing. Then he said, okay, do one thing. You be here, I'm going there, I say something, if you hear, you just tell me yes or no. He went there and he asked me, what's your name? My name is Manish. Where do you come from? I come from India. He came inside, you have no problem. Doctor, I have hearing pain, not hearing problem. He sat down and his goggle pulled down and he's looking at, okay, take this medicine. This pain will go off in 2 or 3 days. I asked, are you sure? If the pain doesn't go away, come after 3 days. If in between, come anytime, but you go now. But then, when I took for the first time one tablet, I was relieved. Second time, I was much better. On the third day, I was totally out of the pain and I became a fan of the doctor. That's my story. Yes.
Any question for you, Arish? Anyone?
You want to make that as your speech? Do you plan to use the story as a speech?
No. I just spoke what I felt to spoke. What I felt to speak. I know I am not funny, but I am here to learn to be funny.
What are the difference between
There are a lot of differences.
Any funny incidents?
Okay, here's a question. If a dentist in Malaysia and a dentist in India, what is the difference?
If you go to India, they will ask a lot of questions first. A lot of inquiries they will do first. Then they will go for medication or suggestions.
Here,
they first jump to the medication. Medication or suggestion. So this is the main difference.
Okay.
It's my experience, by the way.
Okay, thanks. Okay, let's work on it. Okay. Manish, do you have a topic for your humorous speech contest? Looking for Manish. How do I spell your name? M-A-N-I-S-H. Oh, you know everybody's name, huh?
Oh.
M-A-N-I-S-H. J. J. H. A. J.
Ja. J. Ja. Ja. Bing. Okay.
All right. Now, of course, you told a story. That's storytelling. Now, in the story, was there any target? Potential targets you can look at? Maybe, yeah. Hostility against dentists? Yeah. How many of you hate that going to dentists? Who likes to go to dentists? You like to go to dentists, sir? You like to go to dentists, sir?
No.
No, huh? Okay. So we have something against dentists. You know? Okay, let's look at yours. You said you wanted to be an engineer. Well, you wanted to be a doctor, but you became an engineer. Why? That's one thing, huh? Okay, your job. Okay, why you be an engineer? Why you become? Why you want to be a doctor? Become an engineer?
Because my whole family wanted to be an engineer, not a doctor.
Okay, want to be a doctor, family wants you to be an engineer, okay? Family wants you to be an engineer, okay, fine. So it would be funny, actually. This one is very funny. Okay, you can make it very funny. I want to be a doctor, my family wants me to be an engineer. I ask, why can't I be a doctor? They say, you bring many diseases back over here. Okay, you know, a doctor, you bring many diseases into the country, you know, into the home. Okay. Yeah, okay. So we don't want to guess. That's one option you want to deal with. Dentist, you can always tell. I have this dentist joke I used to tell. Is it? You know, do you have friends who actually ask questions when your mouth is full? You know, when your mouth is full, your friends ask questions like that? Yes, huh? Gonna? No, never. Okay. So, yeah. So you can throw this question and say, those people who ask questions when your mouth is full should be dentists. I mean, dentists do this, isn't it? They will always be looking at you, and then you line up there and go, how are you? They say, long time no see. Dentists always do that. They always talk to you. Your teeth are really lousy. They can really criticize you and curse and kill you at the same time. Okay, what else can you do for him? Okay, for Manish, what do you think he should say? Guys? Yes, spot on. India and here. Anywhere like that, here could be anywhere. One of the point he said is, this time he said, in India, the difference is, India asks a lot of questions. In Malaysia, they give you medication. That is, your answer is very simple. In India, we ask a lot of questions before we come to conclusion. Malaysia, it begins with the conclusion. See? So that is one thing, okay? One is, you begin to conclusion. You don't conclude to begin. To begin. So that is the difference. What else? You can actually, you have a good thing you can talk about. Everybody talk about people, the way they drive the car here, you know, all the traffic jam. In India, we have to push away the jam to find the road, you know, whatever. No,
You know, they say that in Malaysia, we all talk about traffic jam. You cannot see, you know, the road is always traffic jam. In India, we have to push away the jam to find the road, you know. So, you think about it. Because India is... Here, you're talking about people simply driving. There, you just don't die, you'll be happy. You know, I just try not to die. You know, whatever, you think about it. In Malaysia, you say they complain about people crossing the highway. In India, where's the highway? You know, everywhere. Just think about that, the kind of thing. And you make fun of your own country. Don't make fun too much of Malaysia. Because it won't be funny. Because when you do your things, you make fun of yourself, it's make the audience superior. You see, the thing is, in comedy, it's let the audience think they are smarter than us. It's okay, what? They pay for it. Okay. Yes, yeah. You know me and Logie make them pay for it. So does Steven Fernando. Okay. What else can he talk about? What topic can he talk about which will be funny? Yeah?
Dating in India, dating.
Okay. Okay, is that what happened in India? Huh? Do you have arranged marriage or are you going to find your own wife? What is the chances of... What is the chances... Seriously? Okay. You can talk about, you know, you talk about Malaysian wedding is... You think about Indian wedding is whole night very long. You come to India, if I'm to get married, I will have a 7-day celebration. I'll be sitting there from 8 a.m. until 8 p.m. every day. You know, India's wedding is 7 days, 3 to 7 days long. Minimum, okay, minimum, okay. And the whole idea is very simple. They want to put you through this ceremony so that you don't divorce and marry again. It is funny, you know, do you know that? You know your culture, Indian culture, yeah? They put you through 7 days. Actually, very long one, you know, 12, 13 hours, and then you go, yeah. You divorce, you're so scared, you know. When divorce, you want to get married, you cannot go to Phuket and then Thailand to get married one, you know. But okay, what else? Dating. What else can you talk about for him? What would be funny?
First time in Malaysia.
Huh?
First time in Malaysia.
Okay, what is the first thing you discover about Malaysia that you got surprised?
Exit.
Huh?
Keluar.
Huh?
Keluar.
Exit. Keluar. Oh, keluar. Keluar, okay. Signages. Signages can be very funny also. You guys can talk about signages. You know, we have there's a line we talked about coming line. You know, we ask this question. You know, in Malaysia on the road, we have this round thing with 60, 80, 70, 90, 110. Okay, you know what's that for? That's the amount you pay when you get stopped. You know, this is the only country, Malaysia is the only country in the world where we prepare a place for accident. We call it kawasan kemalangan. So, we talk about signages and you twist it around. So it can be very funny, okay? Keluar, okay, what's so funny? Can you talk about signages?
India.
In India, what do you call it? In Malaysia, it's called keluar. In India, what do you call it? What, you don't use English in India? In India, you have all the states have their own language. Do they? No, lah. You have a bit of different. Okay. All right, one more. Okay, I think this is the best we can do for you now. You only have a little bit here. Okay, what he demonstrated just now is storytelling, okay? And give us an insight of the things that you shouldn't do in the humorous speech contest, okay? So because if you tell too long a story, we don't know where is the punchline. Okay, we have to compact the whole thing and make it funny and find a lot of punchlines. You need to find a target. It doesn't matter what you do. Whatever speech you want to talk about, you need to find a target and hostility. and you deal with an issue, then it will be funny. Then if you look at the exaggeration, it must be real. There must be some acting into it. Don't worry about acting. Try it, okay? Now today, I think we've gone through about 6 or 7 people, okay? We have about 6 or 7 types of materials here where you can mix and match for yourself, okay? And I will send this picture, to Dinesh. For those who don't have, you stick it and see how you can mix and match for yourself, which area you want to go into. Developing material is like that. You just have to write, okay? Now, of course, the next thing is, I will end this one by asking this question is this. Dinesh, sorry to disrupt your conversation with your darling.
No.
Oh, I'm not that way. Okay. So Dinesh, isn't it? I know. Now, this is one of the things I do. I observe people. So when I observe people, I pick it up and I do what you guys do, okay? So one of the things you do is imitate other people. Put it down that imitation is very important, you know? If you're able to imitate even your niece, if you actually want to do this story, you imitate. My niece come to me. Why you make your eyes look like a zombie? You know? Do some action and you can see it, you know? We used to have a play called Hikmah Nagara. I play a young boy, and Logi will play the sergeant. Okay, stay straight! Okay. Stay straight!
Yes, sir.
Why are you in national service?
To serve the country, sir.
To serve the country, you can serve in McDonald's and Kentucky. Why you serve here? So you say, these are action, you play you go into acting and all those things, you can do that. But if you want to act in your speech contest, make sure you act. Go into the acting, you know? And you want to do a woman, you do a woman properly. I asked another auntie, sir, when I was young, they threatened us with only 2 things, my auntie and my mom. They threatened us with sending us to the guy who sells bottle at the back lane, or threatened me with heaven and hell. And my auntie would say this, Atau, if you are naughty, you don't listen to your mom, you will go to hell. Hell. You know? And you think like a woman. In your mind, you see your auntie, you act like your auntie out. Right, so that's what we do. Okay. I think we're going to end this today. Are you agreeable?
Yeah,
I can see you. Wow. So writing, that's why I tell you, comedy writing is a very tiring thing, man. But you have a lot of good materials to work on today. And if you want, Dinesh, do you want to have a session for all of them to present it? You talk to them. If you want, you can always come back. Let me know the date in advance. Then I will give me enough time to find an evaluator for you all. In other words, we go to, that means from 2 to 4, we go through the whole thing, and then we have someone to evaluate you all. Okay, and I will encourage you this. After the evaluation, I may encourage you to try open mic. Open mic, I will show you, I will bring someone from open mic to evaluate you all. Okay, and open mic is a place where we test our materials. As a comedian, we have these open mic sessions, and we just go there and talk. Now, they do a lot of wild materials, okay? Okay, but you can test your materials there and you get more confidence. And you can see what bomb and what don't bomb. And what kill and what bomb. Okay, so I encourage you to do that. Don't worry about that. You know, sometimes you keep doing something you enjoy. I had an interesting time with all of you to see some of the things you're working out here. And I hope you all go back and start writing. Okay, if you don't, you start writing, you just keep on putting points down. Don't forget to just start putting ideas down, even though ridiculous one. Continue to write down, and then you start talking about it. And the next session, you talk to Dinesh, I let him design it, and then we can work out something for you all. Okay? With that, Dinesh, anything you want to say? Okay, so with that, thank you very much. Okay.
Okay. Wow, this looks really fancy.
So anyways, ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause to Monti. He just left, but never mind. So what I'm going to do is I have all of your email addresses.